Ross's body out of enemy hands, no matter what. Get the body safely to the canal escape pod.
Alright, guys. Here we go. It's the Delta Flight Dreaming! Back with Metal Gear Solid 4. Now, like I said, I'm doing my best to not... I don't like that, but... I'll leave that on. So I'm trying to not... You know, have any more casualties than I already did. Rations, pop this on. Because a lot of these guys, you can kind of just, like, zip on by. Oh no, a gate! It's really the ones that you gotta worry about are here. One. Whatever. You're down. Where? Oh. Yes, I see. I'm a little busy, man. Just go! Well, I'm trying to get this guy. Okay, so I need to get her off. Ah. There. Now, okay. Let's see if I can do this. Or is it this one? No, it's not this part. It's coming up here. Two. Three. Got him. Four.
Ready? Hold on.
Okay, no, I think, yeah, this is it right here. Slow-mo. Did I get him? I don't know if I got him. Nope, didn't. Okay, for a dude on a 50 cal, he has absolute dog shit aim. He dead. Yeah, oh, he dead.
Here they come. Snake, watch the run.
Yeah. Now you get some dragon points if you kill those guys. Wow, that was choppy frame rate.
Stop right there.
Come on. It's almost like this, the PS3 is starting to, like, struggle. Ow. Okay, so I've used a ration.
Need help in front.
Yes, I see. I'm watching the truck. I don't see anybody. I believe it's this next section. Ooh, that was a spike. So he just got through that. Oh no!
Hey,
it's pretty much those things. Those things have to cost at least like $250,000 a piece.
More incoming.
I've got bad news. The decoy vans have all bitten the dust, which means the enemy will be focusing on you.
Oh
now.
No.
I just need you to hold them off a little longer. That's right.
I only get 100 points for that? I seriously only get 100 points for every one of those. That's a jip. Calm down. I am calm. Yes, I know. This. Did you sit still?
Come on.
Well, it's a little hard to aim, lady. That works too.
Enemy, get a hit.
We don't really need to worry too much. I want to say it's. There's a part coming up here. Oh, I got them both. Matrix. We're gonna get.
Hey, are you okay?
Yeah, why? Don't stop. The frogs. I think it's right here. Yeah, it's right here. I don't know where that's from. But that's scripted. Like, you can't get around that. It kind of sucks. Swap back over. Now, blowing up those barrels. You shoot the barrel and the barrel explodes, killing the frog. Doesn't count as a kill. Yeah, I'm on it. Use a second ration.
I think we lost them.
Dang. Well, I wouldn't necessarily say we lost them. I think she's just moving to a different location. Hey. My shop.
Oh.
Come on.
Stay oh, no, not again.
Eva, I need you.
Is that you?
It's like, no, it's the other one.
Mother's work is never done.
My mama.
Where's the van?
It's in the Wendy's next door. Well, there's only one.
No. So sorry. She'll be coming to search the van.
No, she won't.
I'll take care of it. You stay here. Keep watch.
I'll contact the children.
Here, take this.
Snake, come back in one piece.
I will.
Promise me.
I don't remember her saying that in three. I mean, I'm pretty sure she probably did, but... Time to go with a pistol. Ah! Wah! And I swear to God, it sounds like he just popped a soda into his vein. Like, oh, the Coca-Cola taste. Oh, right in my neck. Right, pointing right at you.
Let your fury flow freely. Anger begets anger. Come on, show me your rage.
I was just gonna say, where is the fuel tanks on that thing? I'm gonna pop up here. I'm gonna need. I'm here. Because here, this is where we're going to start our fight. Is that her? Yeah, it is. Yeah, because they think I'm down on the first floor still. So let's. Weapons, I'll get rid of that. I will need to get a Mosin Nagant. Yeah, they have no idea where I'm at now. So I gotta go down here. Pretty much alert them to my presence. Over here, lady. I'm right here. See me! There you go. How in the hell did you not see me, like? He's in this room, I swear. He's like 15 feet from me. I'm blind. First one wasn't that hard, but the second hit, when he bounced up against the wall, that sounded like it hurt the most. Let's get underneath here for a second. Just the drones.
Something's coming. Get out of there, Snake.
Yep. Go. Damn it. Just look, I'm right here. No. Oh, he's gonna see me. There you go. did those not hit me? Down. I think there's a limit to how many there are of these. But I don't, not what I wanted to do. She's right there. Oh no, come back! Oh, they hit the walls, that's why they didn't hit me. Yeah, I think she's only got the one. Driven shop to resupply on. Just some of these. Whip, whip. Alright, we're over there. Sit still, sit still, sit still. Oh, that got her. That got her attention. Move, 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 move. Nice side flip. Okay, I just need to calm down for a second. Give you the opportunity. You won't succeed, but I'll give you the opportunity. Okay, that's your last. Very nice. I just saw that, like, you see the little grenade just whoop, right in my face. I do not remember her doing the flashbangs. Alright. She says she's overheating, so what she does is she has to go and cool down on one of these roofs. She's usually... Sure, she's right there. So they're just... beating and banging on the... Wait. What'd she say? That should not have hit her. Maybe one or two more good shots, and we can call phase one of this fight donezo. Yeah, so those things do respawn. Alright, hang on. Alright, so my health is up. I definitely need to do that. Pretty much, I'm just biding time to kind of let my health come up. But no, I'm letting that regenerate a little bit while I have the opportunity to. Is that her? Yeah, it is. Like, how did you not see me? Someone found me. You're a drone. Well, where are you? Is this you? No, you're both drones. That's a drone. Wait. You guys saw me! There you are. There we go. Yeah, like one more good shot. So it took you long enough. Where are you? You're a drone. Where the hell did you go? Not either one of you. What the hell hit me? See ya. All right, phase one is done. I kinda want that helmet. That could have been a good, like, wallpaper for like a desktop or. Booty shot. He's just got that, the fuck? And fan service.
Let me out of this cage.
Okay.
I don't need these wings. I don't need this range.
Oh my god!
Watch out! She's gonna try to grab you!
Really? Thank you, Holly Hindsight! It's not like I haven't done this before. Like, I gotta at least give Otacon credit where credit is due for him. Like, he's trying to be helpful, but it's like, yes, I already know. You know, I'm the one who's experiencing it, as opposed to you just sitting on a plane. One more good shot, and it's over. Ah! We're gonna hear from Drennen, and then we're gonna end the episode. Ah! Oh God! Like, there's no way that she doesn't either have a concussion or a fractured skull. Cannonball! Down a boss, up a grenade launcher. A decent price to pay. I've already got it, but what?
Way to bring that bird down.
Thanks,
Drebin. And you got yourself a souvenir too. A grenade launcher. Nice. That's a real user-friendly weapon.
Yeah, most guns are. Point and click.
Launder this one free of charge.
What's the catch?
Only that you give it to me when you're done with it. A weapon with that many decades of rage stored up inside it. Now that's a collector's item.
How old was she?
I'd say about 20. But she had years of soldiers' rage hidden away in that youthful body of hers.
Soldiers?
Yeah, the soldiers of Ake. A place that hasn't seen peace in a long, long time. She was captured by one side or another, and kept caged up like an animal, along with God knows how many other kids.
Anonymous violence.
Exactly. It's unknown whether her captors were with the government or the rebels. In any case, they got their kicks by abusing these helpless little kids day after day after day. That constant barrage, that battlefield rage slowly built up inside their bodies, their minds. The kids tried to keep each other's spirits up, always clinging to the hope that someone would come to their rescue, barely surviving off of scraps of food. But those soldiers didn't stop. They called the kids parasites and shit-eating ravens, beat them even harder. Then one morning, the soldiers just up and left, leaving the surviving kids to be eaten alive by the birds. Almost like one of those sky burials. One by one, their bodies were picked apart by ravens' beaks, until finally the flock came for her. But by some miracle, their beaks cut her bonds instead. And like that, she was liberated. In that instant, she was filled with an uncontrollable rage, and it smothered her soul. She ripped the ravens pecking at her to pieces, and then went after the soldiers. And when she finally caught up with them, she waited until nightfall, like a hunter awaiting its prey. They say that when a raven cries, a man dies. And that's exactly what happened that night. Screeching and cawing, she killed every last living being in the camp. Both the soldiers and the civilians they'd enslaved. In her eyes, there was no longer a difference. The cruelty her friends had suffered, the pain and humiliation she'd endured, hers was the distillation of the rage that decades of war had imparted on those soldiers.
It was her strength. And her greatest weakness.
You're something else, Snake. You managed to cleanse Raven of her rage. No, seriously. You're the seed of war. In fact, I'd say you might even be war itself.
Draven.
Maybe it's still too early to tell. You've still got half the B&B core ahead of you. Keep your eye on the ball, pal.
All right, guys. We're going to pick it up in the next episode. Thank you so much for watching. Like, share, comment, subscribe if you don't mind. See ya.